awesome animals.
Hello, everyone. Today we'll be traveling to Tenerife and we'll be talking about the Bichon Frise. Please don't forget to smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. The earliest records of the Bichon Frise breed date back from the 14th century, when French sailors brought the dog home from Tenerife, one of the Canary Islands. It saw that Bichon Frise dogs had been taken there by traders who used the Phoenician trade route, and that the Bichon Frise originally developed in Italy. The Bichon Frise is often deprecated as a French dog, although the Bichon breed type are originally Spanish, used as sailing dogs, also as herding dogs sometimes, the French developed them into a gentle lapdog variety. The Bichon Frise is considered a great all-around pet that is a playful yet gentle dog. Bichons get along well with other pets. They are generally considered very good with kids. In one survey, they ranked high on snapping at children, but caution is in order any time dogs and small children are together. In the same survey, they were found easy to housebreak and train, but some owners disagree with the easy housebreaking label. The Bichon dog breed, with a lifespan of about 12 to 15 years, is prone to some serious health problems, like allergies and palate luxation, or from less serious conditions like cataract and canine hip dysplasia, leg growths, and liver disease may also affect the breed. Fully grown, a Bichon Frise will reach a height of 9.5 to 11.5 inches. Typically, they weigh a manageable 12 to 18 pounds. The Bichon had early success in Spain. In the 14th century, Bichons were rediscovered by Italian seafarers who brought them back to Europe. Their breed quickly became a favorite of Italian nobles. They became popular in France during the Renaissance, but saw their greatness and success during the court of Henry III. It has been said that Henry III loved his Bichon so much that he carried it in a basket that hung from his neck. The Bichon has a white coat that is blush, relatively hypoallergenic, and sheds very little. This is because the shed hair gets caught up in the dense undercoat, which requires daily brushing to prevent mats from forming. This breed needs frequent grooming, thanks to their relatively long, curly double coats. The fluffy white dogs originate in the Mediterranean. Their ancestor is the Barbet Water Spaniel, which gives them the name Barbichon. This moniker was later shortened to just Bichon, which means lapdog in French. From there, the group was divided into four subsets, the Bichon Balinese, the Bichon Havanese, the Bichon Maltese, and the Bichon Tenerife. Each name refers to the region where the type was bred. The Bichon Tenerife eventually became the Bichon Frise. Frise means curly in French and refers to the pooch's locks. Italian sailors kept the companion dogs to be used for bartering. They eventually found their way into the hearts of Spaniards and flourished on the island of Tenerife in the Canary Islands, where the Bichon Tenerife originated. Italian sailors eventually rediscovered the dogs in the 1300s and brought them back to mainland Europe. The tiny dogs were a big hit among Italian nobility, who would give the pups lion-style haircuts. In the 19th century, Bichon Frises grew popular as entertainers. Audiences found them performing frequently in circuses and with street performers like organ grinders. The breed's clownish personality and friendliness made them well-suited for old-timey show business. The famous Spanish painter Francisco de Goya included dogs in many of his paintings, including several works that depicted Bichon Frises. This painting from 1819 is titled Las Jovenes o la Carta, Young Women with a Letter. It can be found in the Palais des Beaux-Arts de Lille en Paris. Despite stereotypes, not all canines love water. Count the Bichon Frise under the category of dog breeds that don't like water. It makes you think about all the Bichon Frises those Spanish sailors brought with them aboard ships hundreds of years ago. We suppose there wasn't much worry about the dogs jumping overboard. Despite their long-standing popularity in Europe, Bichon Frises are newcomers to the US. The first litter was born on America's soil less than 60 years ago, after a French family brought their Bichon Frises with them when they moved to Michigan in 1956. Two American breeders got their hands on Bichon Frises of their own in 1959 and 1960, and from there the breed gained popularity quickly. The American Kennel Club recognized the breed in 1973. A Bichon Frise named Special Times Just Right, aka Junior, won Best in Show at the 125th Westminster Kennel Dog Club show on February 13, 2001. At the time, Bichon Frises had made it to the final ring at Westminster only 3 times. Junior became the first and is so far the only Bichon Frise to win the coveted title. The champion dog died in 2012 at the ripe age of 15.
If you've enjoyed this video, please smash that like button and subscribe to our channel for future weekly videos. See you guys next time, good! Bye!